Hello. I think Kenyans have lost their souls to vanity. Their minds, South Africans, Nigerians, and Tanzanians have taken over. We celebrate their music, food, and fashion more than we even notice our own. On this show, we're going to be talking about food, music, and fashion. I am Shamila Kito. Welcome, Shamillucia.
Kenya, pamoja, kupendo na amani.
Surely, a person of your caliber wouldn't have accepted being dressed like that.
What brand are you holding right now?
Sailo unapakulia mtu kwa sahani, unamwekea kachumbari kando kidogo.
If there are cows, I'd have to teach you cows that can interview me.
Oh, Lord. Like I said before, our airwaves are filled with different music from our local. What we actually think that should be played as local music. Because we are Kenyans, we need to embrace what we have. And like I keep repeating every other time, even on my blog, I keep saying we need to embrace Kenyan music. I don't understand why the Kenyan artists cannot get to the level where they should be, or their videos and singles and production and everything cannot get to the level where we actually accept to have music from outside brought to our airwaves, which is like 24 hours, and apart from 5 songs, 1 is local. We need to understand the whole system. I cannot explain everything to you, but I have someone with me that can actually give you the whole why, where, and when, because he's been in the music industry for a minute. I have for you Mbuvi.
Yes.
Mbuvi, welcome.
Asante.
How have you been?
Great, enjoying myself.
Since the last time I saw you.
Poor.
Apparently you had medication for your voice. But
now it's better. Okay, not better, Kabisa, but it's better.
Don't break the screen, so bad. Anyway, Kenyans need to understand
yes.
where we're coming from with our local music. I mean, I have grown up knowing Genge, mm-hmm. Genge music. Mm-hmm. You know, like Nonini and the rest. Mm-hmm. But we have grown as an industry. The problem comes where we don't get local airplay as much as we should be. Yes. What do you think is a problem?
It's an ordinary problem where a prophet is not respected at their own place. I think that's it. We are getting more gripped and excited about what comes from without. Yet what is within is also excellent, is also good. We need to get to a point whereby we need to appreciate our own. I don't know, I think I'll be a kai going back to where we came from. I think when we were colonized, we always believed what comes from out is better than what is within. It's our mentality that needs to shift. We need to come to understand that no, who we are and what we have is great. It is awesome. Our music is winning awards left, right, and center. We've had Mama Awards being won. We have YRSG winning which awards from which part of the continent. So our music is up there. So we need to just have a mind shift and say what we have is nice. What we have is excellent. What we have can work. Once we do that, then we are in A-list anywhere we go. I know an artist from Cameroon called Richard Bonner. He sings in, I don't know what their local dialect is. That's what he sings. But one day he decided, let me do a song in English. The guy is excellent. But he's trying to tell you, hey, what I have is better from my land.
Okay, from what I understand, the gospel music, the gospel industry itself has come a long way.
Yes.
And guys actually are getting awards and blah, blah, blah.
Yes.
When it comes to secular music, okay, gospel is gospel. Whether you like it or not, you have to, you know, do gospel. Although yeah. some gospel shows in the morning on TVs and radios do South African as well, Zambian, yes. Zimbabwean yes. music. Yes. But still you guys get to, like, you know, have it's a fair airplay. But when it comes to secular music, then we'd rather have Mafiki Zolo, we'd rather have all the Nigerians are like a million and one, I can't even mention. Is it that our music is not danceable? Is it our music that is not what we get from what is being done?
No, it is. The music, secular and gospel, all have grown very well. The level of exposure, shining the spotlight on what is good, is what matters. What has made the gospel industry bloom and blossom in the latter years is probably Groove Awards. Why? It's recognizing our own. When we recognize our own, everyone starts saying, hey, this guy is actually good. This guy is good too, even this guy. So if we can also, maybe one of the steps we could do is make our awards also shine. Then we'll start saying, hey, okay, we have good stuff. Because just the other day I was listening to radio and I heard on Kiss, and they said, next we're going to play the Song of the Year, Groove Award Song of the Year. Why are they playing it? Because it's just got recognized. Exactly. So the spotlight is on that. It is happening. So it's put there. It's
just. But then that's for a second. It's not like, it's just like, okay, say they got an award. We have to do this because, I mean, it was there. It's been proven.
It was there.
Yeah.
But you see, this gives it more mileage. An award is just a platform for you to be seen. It's a spotlight.
Great. So I'm 100% sure there are a few questions that my viewers would like me to ask you.
Cool.
And that is the time when I fry you a bit. So is Mbuvi in a relationship? Is he married? Is he seeing someone? does he have a clande?
I'm sweating. Where is the people to wipe my face? Anyway. Mbuvi is single.
Single.
You did not come here with your lady. You did Sorry? Not come here with your assistant. Anyway.
I'm single. And happy at the moment.
Why is it single at this age? I mean, you're a handsome guy, intelligent, you got it going, celebrity status and all that.
I think everything happens in phases. At times we run races based on other people's races. We say when we get here, we get married. Maybe there's your own individual race. I understand myself. And when I understand myself, I know this is not the time for this. There could be a time that comes for that.
But that doesn't mean you don't have needs. So how do you meet this need?
Everybody has needs in different angles and in different spheres. Now, your character will determine how. You don't have to have what you want to have at that particular moment. You don't have to. You can actually be strong enough to say, I can stop with this for the moment until the right time. Otherwise, you'll always go ballistic with, I want this.
Of course, there's a temptation part where for
yes.
a man.
Yes.
And there's a lot of, you know, like 50 million skin lightening processes and,
yes.
you know, big balloon bumps and, you know, coming along.
Oh, my God.
You must be one of those. You either here or there. So
focus. Focus is the thing.
And prayer.
Focus is the thing. Focus and prayer. That's, yeah. Prayer makes you focus. We're all weak. We're all weak to some of these things. But somehow, when you're focused in what you want to achieve, I want not only to be a successful musician, mm-hmm. but a mentor. If I want to be a mentor, it's the story that is written in my life and not already, before even I speak, who I am is already mentorship enough. So if I let my needs get in the way of the character and the kind of image I'm creating, then I'm in trouble. I have to be strong. I believe in God, but in a sense, we are so physical, God is a little bit far. You get? So if it's a little bit far, it's who I am around my surrounding that will determine how somebody will see me and say, okay, there must be God in that person. So you have to shape your life to reveal that.
You need to advise the girls right now, because at the moment everyone thinks that the socialites that are taking over Nairobi, you talk good about them, you give them good
time.
Whatever. Yeah. If you talk bad about them, you're told they're not here to raise your kids. It's you to raise your kids. But I'm thinking social media plays a bigger part in that.
Yeah.
But anyway, before we get to that point where you'll have to talk about it,
yeah.
and I have to put you a bit on the spot, we have to talk about the two new videos that have been creating whirlwinds and all that on media. That is Falma Mapenzi and Nishike by New Soul. So we have to put this guy on the spot. We have to know what he thinks as a musician, as an artist, because not all of you guys talk about your videos. And I'm even told you don't even give each other advice as if it's good or bad. You just say, yeah, wow, let's go.
No, we do, yes.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're still with Mbuvi. Mbuvi, please, I know we have to get to the pilau part, but you have to, like, give us a little bit more of your time. Yes. So, we were to talk about Nishike and Mfalme wa Mapenzi.
Yes.
Please, tell me what you think about it.
I have interesting views. Uh-huh. You know, Waswahili wanasema, chema cha jiuza kibaya cha jitembeza. Now, these guys are all vocally gifted. Sauti Sol can sing the world over. So at times I think, if you can really, really sing that way, your voice, and even they're good looking, those are enough
six
to
packs.
Get... before we get there, no, okay. that's enough to get your attention. They already have your attention. They probably didn't need to go that route. Same thing with Sanai Paitande. Because I think what Sauti Sol sings is unique. Same as Sanai Paitande's voice. She's really, really gifted. Now, when you swim into the kind of music that they are doing, that's where everybody else is at. So you will not be remembered as a legend. You will hit. But tomorrow another one will come and will hit and you're forgotten. What they were doing is already legendary stuff. So I'm thinking probably that, in terms of even where you're seeing yourself at, may not be long lasting. It'll make you hit, yes.
You know, you're getting me to the point where I have to remember Joe and Boyz II Men and those groups where, I mean, they used to sing same love kind of songs, but they, like, Joe had a love scene kind of song.
Mm-hmm.
And I still remember the song.
But look at Boyz II Men, I'll make love to you. It didn't have to be raunchy. Beautifully sung.
So you're saying this is raunchy. Should we say raunchy?
That's how I felt.
Oh, that's how.
And I felt that's not the direction. Well, maybe I felt like that because of, you know, at times you judge something not based on how bad it is, but how these people have brought themselves. The kind of brand they have created. Any other person can sing it and you're like, it's fine. The industry, where the industry has gotten, the worldwide is like that. But not for these guys. These guys are unique.
I'm thinking Kenyans, if you will agree with me, I'm thinking Kenyans are trying to get good or better at music than, you know, they usually are. I mean, you can see Nigerians are getting better every other day.
Yes.
They're getting their attention, we're playing their music, we're listening to their music. Every other club we go to, we like dance to their songs.
Yes, yes.
But now we kind of have to get to that level where, okay, I'm doing a love song and I just don't need to, like, sing it because I'm sitting on a chair thinking, you know.
Yes. Yes.
I mean, it's a move. I'm thinking it's the right direction. Okay, that's my opinion.
It depends. It makes sense.
It's my opinion. You think it's raunchy.
That's my opinion. Although I think even for them, even the controversy itself will sell them. There are many ways of looking at it. It could work for them, bring that argument and say, yes, music is here, we need to go here. Yes, musically, yes. But what does it do to your brand? And what kind of brand do you want to have?
I'm thinking that's the kind of brand they want to have. Like, Sanepe is a very sexy woman. She's got a very good voice. The video did not bring her out because they didn't oil her legs. They didn't, you know, like, hold her hair up. And we need to see more of that. Okay.
I'm thinking.
You're getting me scared because now.
Whether Sanai Paitande shoots the video like that or not, we already know she's sexy. That already sells her.
She's bringing it out in her video. This is a love song. The guy was dead. Rest in peace, whoever that man was.
which man? Really,
the man in the video. He did not. He was
bring
like,
out whatever you.
Yeah, you. I pull you here. I take you there. Sleep like a dead person. Rest in peace, whoever was on that video. Really, I don't know who it is. They kind of tried. We're looking for that song that will be played on MTV. And
yes,
Kenyans
okay.
are doing everything. Kenyan artists are doing everything to get to that point where my song will be played on MTV. P-Unit came with their song Love, Love, Love. I love the tunes, but the words didn't make sense to me. Mimini, Mbunge, what. It really, that's not a love thing. Don't introduce yourself 100 runtimes from what you've been doing. Okay, with Nishike, of course, women melted and went crazy.
Yes.
I'm so crazy about it. the six packs, the oils and everything. But I don't understand. When you do a video and before it's launched on air or before it's given to people to play it, TV stations, radio, you have to check it first. You have to take a look at it first, right?
Yes.
So when you look at it, you are free to actually say, I don't want this, I want this. Is it, it's good to play or not?
Yes.
Okay, so I think because the ladies in the videos, again, were like a bit scared. They're feeling like this is going to be a bit raunchy, but we need to do it because we're getting paid, we're models. And the lingerie was really like my grandmother's, I must say, because it didn't mean anything. Anyway, so
my
that's
point
what I'm saying.
Exactly.
If you're going out,
yes,
go big or go home.
Yes.
Do
something you know you're the best at. You get my point?
Exactly.
You're good at, you're excellent at this. There are songs, some of these guys, when they do, you know this is their domain. You, even at their worst, they shake the whole industry. So when you shift that just because this is a trend and you're not very good at it, that's what
happens.
Guys,
I think he's trying to mix his words. You said you have to go with the trend. I used to do nice, now I have to go and ding.
You have to go with the trend, exactly, but maintain your brand.
Okay.
You have to go with the trend, but make sure your brand stands out. If you go with the trend and your brand gets swallowed, you're in trouble.
Thank you so much for being with us today.
Yes!
Immediately we get back. Yes. Thank you so much. This guy freaks me out. Welcome back, everyone. With me, I have Pauline Cosmetics. She's a lady I have known for a minute, but I never thought she would end up. If you look at this, I think it's a little bit stressful to get the right colors, the right, oh Lord, amount. Anyway, so please welcome. I'm actually very happy to meet you after, it's been 5 years?
Almost, yes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And then you came back with a bang.
I did. It was not sort of preconceived, but it was in the pipelines for quite some time, but I had to do it. It was one of those things, better done than perfect kind of thing. So I had to just, it felt like the right moment to do it.
Awesome. Okay, give me the challenges, how you actually even come, you even to came that. To think about it, yeah.
I was in Indiana University School of Nursing. Mm-hmm. You know, I enjoyed that. I enjoyed the science of, you know, healthcare and all that kind of stuff. Then at some point, there was such a good opportunity mm-hmm. to be able to have a makeup line because Kenyan women, I think, take time to put themselves together. We spend so much money on hair. We try to look for the right outfit. There was that disconnect of makeup. And I was trying to figure out why, even up to this point, there was not that much effort in it.
Has it been easy?
Yeah, there was definitely the challenge. So unlike the housewives who, you know, they have a lot of things already set up. And you can go private label a product and bring it to the market, but there's, even if you're private labeling a product, there's still the business end of it. You have to build a brand, mm-hmm. You have to create clientele, you have to get repeat customers, you have to get production going. So once I did that, I sort of tweaked the products a lot. And I was actually doing this while I was in class. Mm-hmm. My psychiatry class, which was absolutely boring, I had this professor who was just so monotone. So I was designing all the products while I was in class. So the product that I really tweaked a lot was the mascara. And I like saying that I was making the mascara for myself because mm-hmm. I would put on mascara, any mascara, and then when I would go to use a makeup remover in the morning, my eyes would be really red.
Exactly.
So I wanted a mascara that I could easily wash off with soap or whatever, but would still stay on good. So I kept changing it and changing it, the formulations and all that kind of stuff. I think at some point the chemical engineer was really getting impatient with me.
This is very hard for me to say, but I have to say it anyway. That's why I'm here. Most ladies who go on the red carpet would either get the dress right and the makeup wrong, or the makeup right and the hair wrong, and there's a lot of clown moments. We're going to talk about the Groove Awards, talk about a few ladies on the red carpet, the dresses, the hair, and of course, to make it fun and make it out there, I don't want to put her on the spot. We're going to have Hamisi join us.
Yay, thank God.
I know you feel a little bit tense. We'll be right back.
But at least she was trying to color block.
But it looks, I mean,
I'm both actually offering myself, like, really.
Okay, my bad.
Oh, cheap plastic weave.
Oh,
welcome back, guys. We're on the red carpet. This is Groove Awards 2014. It was exciting. It was entertaining. We had the most fun. You have to welcome Hamisi, like I mentioned before. Hamisi is a makeup hair artist. It's a freelancer, loved by so many. He's done a lot of wedding makeups and
actually did your wedding.
Oh yeah. Forcing it. He did my wedding makeup, yes, and hair, and he took care of like everything, and yeah, I look gorgeous, thank you. Now they know. So like we had mentioned, red carpet has its own issues. Red carpet has makeup stories that fail, dresses, shoes, the clutch bag, that we need to, I would rather say educate our celebrities. Hamisi, what is it that is very important on red carpet?
Okay. First and foremost, what is red carpet? Like, it's supposed to be about glamour and glitz. So when you're invited to a red carpet thing, I mean event, the organizer has put so much into organizing that stuff. So why don't you make that effort also, you, to be part of the party? Like, you look good, you look glamorous, you look, you know, part of the red carpet thing. And maybe go with glitz. I mean, go with chunky jewelry, something that is, when you're seen, it's wow, it's a red carpet look. Yeah, that is my take about red carpet look.
Awesome. The makeup?
The makeup has to be balanced. Mm-hmm. It can be big and bold, but not competing with everything that is going on. Cool. If you have very crazy, crazy in an amazing way gown, you could probably tone it up a little bit here. It could still look very pretty, but you know, not having too much going on. I would say just go with the basic standard rule. If you have bold eyes, you know, kind of go soft on the lips. If you have very bold lips, unless you know you can really rock what you're wearing. Otherwise, you end up looking like you're so busy. Again, you have chunky jewelry going on. You have super big gowns going on. Just keep it classy. The word is classy. Yeah.
So we have Masi Wairigi. And I'm going to have to let you go fast.
Masi had something like a purple dress, of which we kind of like, I would say it's something that would fit for red carpet. This is a kind of like a contour dress that is something that is kind of like hugging your body. So why don't you actually have that body to rock that dress rather than having, I would say she's having like three stomachs to me, because the dress kind of like hugs her boobs and her waist, and the hips are kind of like, see, like she has three proportions. Yes. I mean, to me, that's not acceptable.
Okay, I mean, if to her defense, though, I mean, she's a woman. Maybe with children, those things are not are no. going to be there. But, okay, maybe the thing is, she
Angie,
could have found a better fitting dress.
No, don't give me excuses of having babies. I mean, look at
we
people like, exactly, in the
baby.
Gym.
Those
I mean,
people have
before you rock that red
trainers,
carpet. And
you know?
No, that's not acceptable at all.
Okay,
I mean,
guess the point is she could have found a better fitting dress, but I mean roles aside, those things, you know.
Okay, let's go. I'm for the first time I'm gonna go on the positive. I mean it's a perfect dress for the red carpet. The shoes and the clutch match, and she's got enough jewelry that actually kind of goes with it.
She could have actually done with one less bracelet.
One less,
exactly. I think so.
But when you talk about chunky, this is where people need to know how to maximize and minimize the amount. Yeah, so that's like the other side of too good. It goes all the way bad, and then too much is...
Exactly, yeah. You don't have to put on everything that you own in your wardrobe or something, like everything, no.
Oh, just yeah, and yeah, the makeup.
Look simple and...
Yeah, the make. She didn't do any makeup. I think she put on Fair and Lovely and Vaseline on her lips, and that was it. And again, I know this is a Christian award, but... I'm sure God loves people in makeup too. So this, I mean, just because you want to look, I don't know if it's just, and maybe that's the misconception that because I'm doing gospel music, then I'm not supposed to wear makeup. You can still wear makeup and look pretty and still be very godly. But it's not, she didn't do anything. There's even nothing to
And I would also want to talk about her hair. I mean, that's, I don't know whether she's having some braids or no, it's a weave, but to me that's a cheap weave actually. Because, okay, rather I would even say if she wanted to rock a weave or something, but be creative, do something like fancy, you know, like put it up or something. Or, but that look to me, it's like she's on her way going maybe to the, I don't know, on Sunday going to church.
Chama.
Going
but
to
I won't
Chama
even
or
blame
something.
This guy so much, because when they go to the hairstylists, you know, and they say, I'm going for an award, maybe some of this blame has to go to stylists, because you're styling somebody who's going to an award. You should
but
know.
Then again, we have a hairstylist like Hamisi who cannot be reached. And if they are, then their prices are way too, like, over the roof. So you have to actually afford a stylist. But anyway, it says in the industry, and I know exactly what you want to say. This industry has a lot of stylists, but you need to go to someone who knows what they're doing. So unfortunately, I'm not going to say it's because she couldn't afford it or because the hairstylist was like confused, but yeah.
It looks like, yeah, it's like an everyday look. Goes
exactly,
office,
exactly.
Right?
To me, that's not a red carpet look.
She could do big hair, you know, of course, no makeup. And anyway.
Anyway. Unfortunately.
Yeah, like really, I really needed to talk this, like for real. Like,
I have to be
why
here.
Would you be, my God, what happened? Like, Shamila, I mean, you of
and
all
you
the people,
being in
I
the
didn't
fashion
expect
industry?
That. I mean, you've been there for how many years?
Exactly.
Like, you rock catwalks in Italy, and I mean, so what
guys.
Was that?
It's my time to get this.
What,
can I reggae?
What
they can
was
be
that? Can you?
Okay, no, maybe because the other guys are not here to explain it. I can actually tell you. Okay, so we got an invitation, my husband and I. And of course, my husband is spectacular when it comes to events and he dresses up and all that. And I'm having short dresses in my wardrobe, like they're all short. And this was a Christian event. So I could not rock my short dresses because I felt like I need to respect their thingy, because they actually would not come to a mosque dressed in shorts and hot pants and all that. So I didn't have a long dress. So and I'm doing all this to actually support local. So when I say support local, it's local music, local food, local chefs, local designers. So I called Afro Street Collections and they came up I was happy because I had something to wear.
I have no beef with your dress personally. I mean...
Okay, to me, actually, the whole look, I mean, from her hair, her makeup...
I think the only thing that was actually...
itself, I mean, Shamila, no, I think you could have done better than that, really. Like, the fabric to me is far way too cheap for that kind of event. I mean,
I actually kept sweating.
There you go. I mean, a person of your caliber wouldn't have accepted being dressed like that. I mean, I'm sorry, but you know,
I feel like crying because I'm here.
I have so much beef with your dress because just coming from the previous dress, this is a notch high. The only thing is, why are you wearing glasses at a red carpet?
I can't exactly. See.
Wear contacts.
It doesn't go well with the makeup. Like, most times
you're hiding your face.
No, most times you're here. Okay, I have issues with contacts. As much as I'm a tomboy, I have issues with makeup and all that. I can't even look at my hair. It was just.
Yeah, and then what's up with that, by the way?
I don't have much.
and then again, this is what I was talking earlier. Lipstick alone is not going to save you. So just rocking a red lip and then, you know.
Actually, the whole look to me, if I were to rate you, is something that maybe money-wise was something worth whatever. I mean, it would be something roughly like, I would say 550.
Oh my God! Are you serious? Do you know how much I bought this dress for?
A place somewhere in River Road for that fabric. It costs like 75.
Unfortunately, I have to say this. Okay, my husband, my dear husband, I hope you heard that. We need more expensive clothes. And number two, this is from Afro Street Collection, so the designer needs to up her game.
I'm actually offering myself, like, really. I need to, like, vamp up your wardrobe. Like, really, we need to do something.
Oh my God.
Yeah, it's that serious.
Okay, I'm sad. But anyway, I like dishing, so let's go to the next person since it's not me. Okay, that's Betty Bayo. She actually got 2 awards. Wow.
Betty Bayo.
She looks
my
like
God.
A bridesmaid.
Actually, yeah.
Because like a bridesmaid
the dresses, you see them every Sundays mm-hmm. and every weddings.
I think it's the easiest thing that Kenyans come across when they're going for a red carpet event because it's chiffon and it's long and that's, they think that's it because it has...
But that's the whole thing. I think we Kenyans, I think we don't get the whole concept of red carpet. Mm-hmm. I mean, red
maybe
carpet.
We should next time you do like red carpet redefined, where people actually get to know what is red carpet and what you wear to a red carpet.
Exactly.
Versus,
exactly.
You know.
Okay. Yeah. All those things. I think. Okay. The dress is a little bit.
It's not there. It's not all.
It's not there to me. She looks like she's from a wedding or she's going to a wedding. She
and the
plastic earrings and the cheap weave. I mean that clutch bag and I don't know whether she's. I don't know the type of shoes she's wearing. But no, and then there's no makeup on that lady.
Absolutely
at all,
no
like
makeup.
Really no makeup.
Bad hair, again,
but
red carpet.
But then you have to understand, apparently she has a lot of dramas going on with her husband being a pastor and...
Don't give me that, Shamila, that's not an excuse.
Again,
like, that's not
just
an excuse, really.
It's not, okay, again, this misconception of, and if I'm wrong, somebody forgive me somewhere, but just because you sing gospel does not mean you will not enter the... gates of heaven because you wore.
You're not
makeup.
Supposed to look.
I have to say this. There's this joke going around. Okay, apart from the tinting, where Nigerian guys are actually making fun of Kenyan women with a lot of makeup. They're like, you know, please when you go to church, make sure you don't put that much makeup because God will not be sure where He's sending the blessings.
That's funny because to me, actually, if you ask me, West Africans are the ones who can do put a lot of makeup.
Okay.
Ask Kenyans, no, I don't think like.
Okay, our last photo. My favorite, size 8.
Size 8,
yeah. Okay, I like her hair. It's very bold. And then again, I guess she just turned into
Angie, that's
but
cheap plastic weave. I mean, you can't rock that.
But it looks, I mean, it's bolder than what most people wear.
No way, no,
you know?
No,
okay,
no.
You can get expensive, bold Canada.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, at least she tried to go the mile.
$450,000.
Yeah. If you have that money, you can afford spend. It. Yeah, but no, she's bold enough. She's bold enough to try to, even though, you know, she's, the point is she's singing gospel, but she's aware of
okay,
her
yeah,
style.
Yeah.
No, the whole idea is here, Angie, let's not lose it. It's the red carpet look. This is not like just your kawaida look. This is a red carpet look we are talking about.
Yeah,
here.
And so, it's a nice dress, but it's a wedding dress. It's not a,
and then
yeah,
you don't have to you don't have to match your shoes.
Like it
with
looks
your
like
hair.
A
like what is she
candy
like
wrapper
red hair and red shoes? Surely no.
Oh,
no.
Yeah,
and
but
even
at least
if she was trying to color block, I mean, is it? I don't know whether it's color blocking or something, because I'm seeing like silver jewelry and the dress has got some gold going on and the clutch
and
bag.
And the clutch is way too big.
No, she actually, she just, I don't know, that look
that was
for
a
me.
Well, I think she was trying to do this red hair, red lipstick, red nail polish, red, it's too much matchy, but I will give her an applause that it looks like the event was during the day. So the makeup is not on too heavy, but at least she has
red
lipstick.
Carpet, my dear.
And
it's
like,
red carpet. It wasn't during the day.
Oh, it looks like the photo is okay. My bad. My bad.
Okay, guys. If we continue with this, we have so many photos. We have Hamis is on fire. So we have to cut it off because Pauline has to show us how to do the looks.
So today what we're going for is a little bit smoked out eye and a very bold lip. It's basically like we'd say the red carpet look has to be bold and has to be all out there. So I'll just start off by cleaning off her face and you want to make sure that the face is well moisturized before you start the process. It's like starting to prepare your canvas like an artist before they start working. So the first thing I do is I prep the eye and basically highlight the eye and highlight certain places of the face, because there are certain places of the face that the light hits, and there are places that are naturally highlighted and there are places that are naturally contoured. So basically you want to highlight this part of the face with a lighter shade. You can go a shade lighter or two shades up. So this is the place that you want to highlight. You want to highlight the bridge of your nose. Again, the light is going to hit right at that area. And then you want to also close your eyes, please. I highlight the eye. Mostly you do that to sort of cover up the darkness around the eye, to also just help it pop it up. But again, it also helps me just set that foundation for the skin. So basically I will also highlight this part of the eye naturally, because this part of the eye is normally dark. Okay. And then basically just try to blend it out. Okay, I will need her face, so. So what I'm doing basically is just blending her out. I know it looks a little bit clownish right now, but it will all fall into place at the end. So you want to get those places first, because once you layer up your foundation, it will basically be a done deal, so that you're not doing your foundation first and then your concealer or your highlighter. And you want to take time with this, because I mean, there's no rush. You have like a whole day to prepare for red carpets, I hope. And for the most part, you kind of want to get a makeup artist to help out with this. A lot of people don't wear makeup because maybe they think it's expensive, or it's expensive to hire a makeup artist. But it's a very special day, and you might as well just do it, or take time to learn it. You know, you can pay somebody very little money and they can show you what to do, and you can do it by yourself. So the next stage is basically, and the reason why I'm not so much focusing on this is because I kind of had pre-done that eye. So I'm going to do her foundation. Foundation has to match your skin. This is, the lights are going to be on you, and then again, you don't want to look like you have five shades going on. So I had pre-tested my model, and what I found was that I have to mix two shades to come up with something that works. So, and that's fine. We change with seasons, our shades, tones change with seasons, so it's okay to own more than one liquid foundation. So basically, I'm going to mix those two to come up with the best shade for her skin. And you want to basically do very minimal layers, keep buffing, minimal layers and keep buffing. It's sort of like whipping up a cake. You don't put everything together. You sort of like have this sequence to things. So just blending it out, getting it on all the way into the hairline, because again, what I've seen sometimes is that women will put oil on their hair and then they will have this shiny spot on the forehead and makeup on the other part, so it looks really tacky. So you want to get it into the hairline as well, and you need to blend it out. And this is when again you come over with your foundation to the places where you had highlighted, and you go over it with foundation again. It's basically building up a very nice base, nice canvas to work with. I'm going to turn my model a little bit and just try to blend it out. So you want to get in on that neck, because again, you don't want two shades of skin tones. So you want to get in on there. Just make sure you're blending her out, even into her ear. I know it feels funny. And then just blend it out. Just, it's like, again, making pancakes. You want to whip the hell out of that bowl. Excuse my language. Keep going back. Again, just layering on your product. Again, those details really, really matter. You have to get everything evened out. The key is knowing how to wear makeup. Again, just because maybe you are not a makeup person does not mean you can't wear makeup properly. So get in on that eye area, because again, that's where the light hits. Make sure you buff it out very well.
Don't you know, don't you know, oh, beautiful.
right. So then you top it off with a bold lip, because the eyes can rock either way. The eye, you can go nude with your lips, or you can go bold, because the colors on the eyes work with whatever lipstick you wear. But basically, this is the time to shine. This is not a regular day makeup, so you want to basically amp up your makeup. But then that does not mean, you know, you go crazy with colors. Just know how to coordinate the colors. The more natural the colors, the better. Red lips always look best on the red carpets, depending again on what you're wearing with the rest of your outfit. But basically, you can't go wrong with red lips, and you cannot go wrong with a smoky eye. So for a perfect red carpet look, you can go with something like this. Thank you.
All had that pilau, but most times and most places I've had, it's always turned out to be the pilau, famous pilau Jerry. It's not very hard to make, it's easy. And our celebrity chef today is gonna show us how to do it. Ruben Kabaka, please, karibu. Yes, you had it right. It's Ruben Kabaka, the son of the famous Kabaka, although the late, but we still celebrate him, we still listen to his music, and I think he's one of the best guys who actually supported the music industry to where it is today, and they started it, so we actually have to celebrate these people. Ruben, yes. Karibu.
Asante sana.
Leo unatengezea pilau.
Natengezea pilau.
Okay. Kwanza nina swali. Your late father. Alikuwa mwanamuziki. How come umekuja ukakuwa chef?
Ile ilikuwa talent ya mzee, and this is mine. So niliamua mimi niingilie upande wa upishi.
Kwa sababu tunatarajia ikiwa baba ni mwanamuziki, ni mwanaspoti, huenda ikawa hivyo. But anyway, umekuwa chef tuseme miaka ngapi hivi?
For about 20 years now.
That's very good. Yeah. So the pilau must be perfect.
Yeah, it's perfect.
We're going for like step to step, and you know, we said already pilau njeri, so this one?
This is pwani pilau.
Awesome. Guys, you've heard it from him. Like I said before, you have to celebrate local. We have to actually bring ourselves out there, be it music, be it fashion, be it food, and this time it's in the kitchen. Welcome to my kitchen.
Four
onions. You fry them until they are golden brown. Actually, more in Swahili we say nyekundu.
Iwe nyekundu.
So that it changes the color of rice.
Yeah.
Okay. So he cut a whole chicken. He's been frying it. So you actually have to fry it until it's properly done.
Yeah.
Aye.
Then after that, unaongeza nini? Unaongeza tangawizi. Kijiko kimoja cha mezani.
Uh-huh.
Alafu unachukua tena saumu.
Kitungu saumu.
Tena kijiko moja.
Okay.
Cha meza.
Mm-hmm.
Unaweka. Baada ya hiyo unakoroga kwanza ichanganyike kabisa. Kabisa ichanganyike. Shike itani kidogo, brownish kidogo tu.
Mm-hmm.
Ikolee ndani ya kuku. Then baada ya hapo,
mm-hmm,
utachukua nini? Utachukua hii ni pilau masala.
Uh-huh.
Unaweka ndani.
Kwa hivyo ni lazima pilau masala wakati yenye oil ina...
Wakati kitunguu imekuwa nyekundu, mm-hmm, umeweka saumu imeivia ndani kabisa.
Mm-hmm.
Kama vile viungo vingine vile mzima mzima kama huna, tunatumia hii.
Tunatumia hii ya powder.
Ya powder.
Okay.
Alafu unachukua danajira,
mm-hmm,
unaweka ndani kidogo tena.
Yeah, and guys, these are actually spices you can get from the supermarkets. They're always there in bottles. So it's danajira, it's cumin, it's those kind of things.
Alafu unachukua tena dania. Ile ya kusiaga unaweka.
Right, there's powdered dania as well, apart from the dania that we know, the green one.
Bado hiyo, ukoroge kabisa, zingie ndani.
Ikarangike kabisa kwenye mafuta.
Kabisa kwa mafuta.
Ah, yeah.
Kisha karangika kwa mafuta, mm-hmm. unachukua nini, unachukua, ukiwa unaweza tumia nyanya mkebe, ama nyanya fresh, mm-hmm. ama bila nyanya, mm-hmm. itategemea vile we mwenye unataka.
Nadhani kuna watu wanaogopa kutumia nyanya kwa sababu itashika chini.
Itashika chini, ya.
Ukieka ule mchele.
Lakini kwa sisi, tumeizoea, tunajua vile tunaifanya.
So guys, I mean the tomato is optional. You can either put the tomato puree or the fresh tomatoes.
The fresh tomatoes.
Yeah.
Ukoroge, ingie ndani kabisa, ilete ile kala ambayo tunataka.
Okay.
Na maana kuweka nyanya, mm-hmm. ni kufanya mchele uwe soft.
Oh.
Unaweza kula bila mboga, bila chochote.
Oh, okay. Sana sana watu kula pilau na mchuzi. Waswahili wamezoea tu ni pilau na kachumbari. So
Waswahili wengi wanakula pilau na kachumbari.
Na kachumbari tu. So okay, sawa sawa.
Baada hapo tunaweka chumvi kiasi.
Okay. Jiko.
Tunaweka unapima tu chumvi.
He's a professional. He doesn't even have to measure it. Yeah. So for the sake of yeah, viewers, then we have to say like two tablespoons at least, because you're mixing with the rice and sometimes people add potatoes, so it actually sucks in the salt. So
then after that unachukua maji yale ulikuwa umepima ikiwa moto.
Okay.
Unaweka.
Unatia ndani.
Unatia ndani. Kuna mengine tulikuwa tumechukua tumeweka iko hapo. Ni kipimo inaenda
na. Kwako ni kawaida.
Kwangu ni kawaida.
Si lazima upime. Aya. Lakini kwa watu wengine lazima ile kuna ile mchele kombe moja maji vikombe mbili.
Yeah, kama hivi sasa nimepima kwa sababu hii mchele nilikuwa nimepima hapa mara.
Sawa sawa. Yeah, so it's just the usual, it's a universal thing where you just have to measure a cup of rice and two cups of water. It's simple though, it's a bit tricky for me, so
baada hapo
I'm learning.
Then we cover the water ile steam. Chamke. Kisha chamuka tunachukua mchele, tunatia mchele.
So it boils for at least.
Paka imalize maji, wakati inamaliza maji, tunafunika.
Okay,
inaiva pole pole na moto.
Paka. So lazima ureduce gas kabisa chini, kuzi unajua watu wengine wameza kutengeza na maka.
Ya, yeah. Wengine wanaweka juu. So lakini kwa hii sasa unareduce moto kidogo kwa dakika kama 10, kama nisha kata maji. Alafu itakuwa tayari ya watu kukula.
Sawa, sawa. Yeah. So guys, you have it. I mean, it's not very hard to make pilau. It's a simple thing. You just have to have everything organized beforehand. Your spices, the tomato paste and the garlics and that's it. But the most important part of the pilau making is the onions. They have to turn the color, because if the onions are light brown or white, you know, sometimes you just make onions and they sweat and it's, yeah, itakuwa.
Haiwezi leta kala.
Okay, sawa.
Itakuwa hiyo ni kama sasa unatengeza mchele mweupe.
Ya kawaida.
Ya kawaida.
Okay, sawa, sawa. So we have to wait for the water to boil and then we put the rice, and after like, let's say 10 minutes and we're ready to eat.
Kile kitu itakuwa tayari. Aya, sasa mchele ukiwa tayari, unapakua, unaweka kwa bakuli kubwa na masahani zingine. Na utakuwa umetengeza kachumbari kando, umeweka kando. Sasa ile unapakulia mtu kwa sahani, unamwekea kachumbari kando kidogo. Na kama kuna uwezekano una mchuzi, unamwekea mchuzi kidogo kwa kula. Na kama ni hivyo atakula na kachumbari peke yake tu. Sioni yapo mambo itakuwa yamekwisha.
15 minutes later and guess what? The pilau is done. You can actually tell. You can actually tell. Okay, he was so hungry because he had to wait for the pilau. He didn't have anything at all. We had to wait for this. The celebrity chef, Ruben Kabaka, has actually done a meal for everybody, including the camera guys, the cast and everybody. So guess what? We'll be having a good meal tonight. Do this.
We can begin tasting.
Begin?
Yes,
you've been doing this like, you're finished half of it.
Plus kachumbari.
Oh yeah.
Awesome, oh my goodness. Ebu hurry up with this shot, I finished the food. Oh yeah. This is super yummy. Eh?
Okay, super. I found this very fascinating that, like I say, I will keep insisting the son of Daudi Kabaka, the late Daudi Kabaka, I'm sorry, and the fact that he did not become a musician like his dad, he became a chef and actually he's doing a very good job. And it's actually enjoyable, it's palatable, and I'm 100% sure it can be served in any other hotel or restaurant. Again, I repeat, we need to celebrate our local artists, our local designers, fashion, all that kind of thing. And the chefs, I mean, what more can you say?
This is so awesome.
And I was thinking, young generation, the old generation, he finds, I'm very sure if this will be another whole show if I start asking him about music in his time and his dad's time. And this one, I mean, you've seen his video. He's trying to fly or something.
From Musichana Masura Nzuri. Kwata kawaya! Kwata kwata! Can we just kwata the kamtele?
There we go, guys.
Man, just kwata the kamtele. Yes, we just kwata. Kwata the kamtele.
I have to thank everybody that has been on the show with us. I have to thank Angie from Pauline Cosmetics. I have to thank the model who came for us. I have to thank Bubi. I almost said Vumbi. It goes on. And I have to actually appreciate that Ruben Kabaka had time to be on the show with us. And our cast, our camera guys, the crew, everybody else. We really appreciate it. Have a good one.
Lambwa, lambwa, lambwa.
Open up your mouth!
Let me give you a door. I'm going to go. Lambwa, lambwa,
lambwa. That we cannot just sit down and listen to it. Why am I making laws in Kenya? Okay. Celebrating what we have. I am Shamila Kipto. This is The Fusion. That's it.